413 Project Update for January the 18th, 2015. I almost got the year wrong then. I'm reporting live from London. There's a London eye behind me. Picture colours red this evening. It's usually blue on another day, or green, or whatever colour they decide to choose. Why do you mean that? Fine. I have not had much sleep in the past 24 hours, that's why my speech may be a little bit bad. But let's go through, as we always do with project updates, the past few comments, a few that I've pointed out in the past few days. Tanel Pilak, if I got the name right, hopefully, I've got the pronunciation right, says, can someone create a 2014 Atlantic Hurricane Season animation? Now that was already done a few weeks ago, so check it out on YouTube page, I'll put a link in the description somewhere. Same to the Western Pacific animation, which went online last week sometime, and those both online. Eastern Pacific still on the way yet. I don't really have an ETA on that, hopefully a week or two before that one goes online. Reviewing the season 2014 around the Northern Hemisphere. Now, Melissa Spanida says, I went to Mauritius for Joburg at 9:15 on Tuesday the 13th. I didn't want to leave my family or go back to work. That, of course, did reference to Cyclone Bansi, which affected the area around that time, the 14th around the 14th of January. So, very nice to hear that Melissa is safe and well, and hopefully her friends in Mauritius are likewise too. I don't think the storm did too badly over there. Of course, it went off far to the north. Super Typhoon says on the 16th of January at midnight UTC, I think it was, the French Reunion, the weather service, said that Cyclone Bansi was 115 knots in 10 minutes sustained winds, whilst the JTWC said the same thing, 115 knots for 1 minute sustained winds, and I think he wants to know why that is. And I think it's not so much that they're one and the same, because obviously they're not, 10 minute and 1 minute are very different, but they're differing organisations and they may not always agree with each other, so I think that's the reasoning behind that. And Jason Carrymag says, the current storm in the Philippines may interfere with the Pope's visit. Got to monitor this location. Now, I know in the actual updates, I didn't actually mention that event that's going on in the Philippines. The Pope is visiting. I think that visit is ending today, if I remember correctly. The storm will be in the area, but I don't think it's going to be too bad for the Pope visit. And I think we may still see some heavy rain there, though. Of course, that storm is weakening. We'll have an update coming up on that. Time of recording, this is still the 17th, so the storm is still affecting the area. Don't laugh behind the camera, shut up. So, yes, now, it's time to tell you about something rather important that's going on this Monday, which is at the time of upload, tomorrow now, or indeed later tonight even. And it's a new show called Here Today, Storm Tomorrow. You can see the little trailer on your screen right now. And that's coming up on Monday, and it's a new daily series on Force 13, which will pretty much be a mixture of tropical weather bulletins and project updates, pretty much merged into one, with even more content aside from that as well. So that's certainly going to be a very exciting prospect. We're going to have more than one presenting. So finally, Force 13 is not going to be a one-man band, which is fantastic news for all concerned. Stop talking behind the camera, thank you. In 2015 so far, we have seen three tropical storms, two of which have become Category 1 hurricane equivalent storms around the world, and one major storm. Now, by my reckoning, to reach 80 storms throughout the year, you've got to get around one storm every 4.5 days. And the way we're going, we should really have four, but it is January. Even though the Southern Hemisphere hasn't really warmed up yet, Australia perhaps is the one we're looking at mostly there, because we've not seen any storms there yet, apart from Kate, which is far away from Australia itself. So we may see more activity there in the coming weeks. That's certainly, I think the longer we go without activity there in Australia, the more spooky it gets, because usually you get at least one throughout the winter. And finally, Force 13 is setting up a new Skype room, on Skype of course, it's a new chat room, and you can join it as well. Just have Cool 13 on Skype, that's my name, and talk about that, ask to go onto the chat room, and I'll lead you straight through to it, and you can meet like-minded people, talk about storms and everything else that's going on. I'm moderating it of course, as well as one of my other buddies, plan, so hopefully you'll enjoy that as well. Any questions, just send them in the comments section and I'll have them answered in the next project update, which is now part of Here Today, Still Tomorrow. And that starts, guess what, tomorrow. That's all for now. See you again soon.